We're going to analyze one of the most prolific running backs in the history of the league, and we're going to start right now. Now, when we think about running backs, we've got to look at freaks, right? We got to think about someone like Herschel Walker, someone like Barry Sanders, Emmitt Smith, Eric Dickerson, Walter Payton, Sweetness. We want to look at these athletes and see how well they move. We want to see what they're doing with their trunk. We want to see what they're doing with their hips. We know they have to be extremely fast. We know that they have to be extremely powerful. Okay, and we also understand that they have to take a lot of contact. Now, is a running back known for his absolute absurd levels of power output? And that running back is gonna be Marshawn Lynch. And we're gonna go into his cutting ability, his ability to get upfield as quickly as possible, and what he was doing specifically, and avoid people like Ray Lewis. Okay, avoid some of the greatest linebackers of all time. So we're gonna go into this. Here we go. Nice little hands from Marshawn. Let's play this full speed. Look, that's just insane. Like, he's not just making Ray Lewis miss. He's making Ray Lewis, who's top two best linebackers of all time, top three, look like an idiot. I will discount something known as a false step. In instances, I will say we shouldn't be using false steps for certain positions or for certain movement patterns. But if we're training and learning a false step, it's still a skill. Okay, and that's what we see right here. We see Marshawn, he notices what's going on. He's got unbelievable vision. Okay, he's sort of seeing everything gonna be right here, and then he's gonna take it upfield, right? So what can he do? He puts this leg out. He knows where center of mass is. Puts this leg out, and he's known for being absurdly strong. Gets that little inside cut here, comes back, puts all the weight on the inside as though his hips are gonna come to the corner, and then immediately gets small. Look what he's doing here with his trunk. He immediately gets small right here, and he creates this stretch shortening cycle. And what's absolutely crazy here is that this reminds me of a baseball swing. You compress and you come out. And this is almost exactly what he's doing in that position. He gets small, cuts it back, right? Gets that little shimmy, gets his feet set and goes. Puts the foot down and goes. Gets the anchor, and now he's upfield, driving, driving, driving. And what do we see? Look at his shin angle right here. Boom, okay? I wanna go back and look at that little cut. Boom, upfield. As quickly as possible, head on. Unbelievable, that cut, that play, it's like, unbelievable play. And right here we can see a little bit better angle. Look at the head movement. We're talking about dynamic trunk control. This is what we're talking about, being able to control and silence. Look at the head movement, boom. It looks like he's about to go down, cuts. Keeps his shoulders square, gets upfield. And a little drag step, look at the drag step right here. Watch that little drag step. Okay, that little low heel recovery. Boom, plants and goes. Another one. Boom, plants and goes. And so the big factor here is that if we're analyzing this specific play, and we know that this movement pattern involves a whole bunch of different factors. If we go back to this, and I want to get to the angle where we can see from head on, we see some very specific things here. Right here, front foot is in front of the center of mass. Okay, so really, really hard cuts, we have to think about that skill. Front foot, put that out in front of your center of mass. So the way that we can take this information is say, okay, if we're doing training, let's say we have a training system. Okay, let's say we're inside of Peak Strength, our app, and we click on, we wanna train as running backs, and we get a program. Inside of that program, it's gonna be a leg power day, an upper body power day, and it's gonna be an athlete day. What we would do is we look at this and we go, okay, this is going to be a skill that we practice on athlete day. Okay, so we wanna do plyometric series where we might plant here and cut to the side. Okay, so that might be doing something like a version of the Jan Jump series. Okay, now the next thing that we're gonna see here, we see that nice, look at this, how steep that gets right there. So we've gotta have good mobility in the hip. We've gotta have good mobility in our lower back. We're gonna be using things like mobility after our training, but we're also gonna be using resistance-based training inside of our program that's full range to make sure we're training this. Now we can see this plant out here. That's where if we're doing something like a side band jump or a side kettlebell jump, we want to get that wide plant. He's compressing on this left side. He's planting out on that right side. That's where we're going to see a lot of glute med and a lot of quad and even more glute max. He's got this vision. This is the stuff we can't really train. Vision stuff you can work on out on the field with your coaches inside the weight room. You can do a little bit of target practice stuff, but it is more challenging. Okay, so he plants that here, gets this left foot high, and what's he do? Plants inside with that left leg, left side planting. So now the next step, let's look at some type of plyometric movements that we can do with inside power output. So that might mean cutting from the inside leg instead of the outside leg. So we've got to cut from all different angles. Now, the other thing is being able to produce a large amount of power in a very deep position that's unilateral. So that goes back to, okay, we've got to do this at high speeds. That's going to be athlete day. If we can do it at high speeds with high amount of force, that's going to be impulse day. That's going to be our day four of training. I'm not sure we can train this with resistance-based work right there, okay? But what we can do is now we get the anchor. Watch his left leg anchor, okay? And watch how quickly shoulders get to the side. Boom. Now, recently we've done some videos with Nick Singleton, who's the starting running back at Penn State, where Nick was doing forward jumps, landing on one leg, cutting to the side, and then doing another jump. But he would be landing on one leg, landing here and keeping his shoulders square and jumping forward. And the main goal of something like that, that is gonna be done on athlete day, is to keep those shoulders forward while applying a large amount of force. Okay, so then we can get here, we get this little step, which then puts us out and we can accelerate, okay? Watch this comes out. This leg's gonna have that little low heel. Now he can drive, he gets that little chest lean and extends that back leg. Boom, boom. It's interesting too, Marshawn tends to run a bit more toe out. Here's that back angle so we can see. Look at, so we've got to have good strength, good D. This is where I'd say you could do some single leg work that is a bit more slower eccentric. Compress here, boom. We drive out of that compressed position, keep the shoulders square, square up here and drive upfield. Look at the movement patterns. Look at the trunk control that he needs just to initially catch the ball. Then when he rotates, he gets the vision. Then when he gets the vision, he gets into various different positions that require a large amount of mobility and a large amount of power output at very, very high speeds. That's impulse-based training. So what we have to do is full range of motion, back squats, full range of motion, front squats, do them unbroken, do them through different tempos, do single leg squats with more of a forward lean, and then do high speed plyometric series that are gonna emulate those different cuts. If we can practice those different cuts inside of the gym, now we can get more effective as a running back. We can take our game to the next level and slowly chip away. But you guys have to have a specific program to continue to build to that next level. And if you don't have that, head over to peakstrength.app, the Google Play Store, or the Apple iOS Store. You can download Peak Strength for 7 free days of training. Make sure you go in and you select running back. You want to train like one of the best running backs out there. You want to improve your twitchiness. You want to improve your absolute strength. Make sure that you pick up Peak Strength today, because remember, freaks, if you want to become a champion, you've always got to cultivate your power. Peace.